He said that the flesh shall consume away while they stand, and their eyes shall melt in their holes. Read.
And their tongue shall consume away in their mouth.
Now, it only take what? It only take that type of fervent heat to make that happen. You understand? Go talk to somebody that might be old, they're from Japan, they might have lived in Nagasaki, or was that the city? Hiroshima. They might have survived that blast. And they will tell you, oh, it was a thing. It's the what's a thing you don't want to go to. Oh, no, no. America good, oh, sir. You know what I'm saying? That's what's gonna happen. You know what I'm saying? So, you know what I'm saying? You gonna talk to the child while they eat their sushi. Oh, he has some sushi. I'll tell you a story or two. You know what I'm saying? Go ask them Japanese, them old Japanese. They're gonna tell you all the horrific stories. They're gonna tell you what they saw. What they saw was bodies being melted right in front of them. People being left as a mark of shadow wherever they were standing. If they was running this way, trying to run from the fire, guess what? That's how they remained, plaited to a wall.
ISUPK.
Since 1969, I teach the truth to every black man and Hispanic man and Native American Indian, Seminole Indian. You know what I'm saying? Because we're the children of Israel. And this book is about us and for us. You understand? It ain't for everybody. Everybody ain't got to like it. You know what I'm saying? But the truth, nonetheless, is the truth. Now, we had the president of the United States, the white folks' champion, Donald J. Trump. You know what I'm saying? That's their champion, their hero. But their hero is going to bring trouble to them. You know, Trump said today, right, that he's about to bomb Syria because, quote unquote, the Syrian president is bombing his people with chemicals. That's what he told. That's what they've been told to the whole world. You understand? Now, I don't know if that's true. We're not over there to see actually what's going on. But what I do know is that Russia said if you bomb Syria, America is in great danger. So right now, America is in the UN, having a council of whether or not they should bomb Syria. You understand? And guess what? Hard-headed Donald Trump is going to go ahead and more likely go ahead and do it. You understand? Which we hope so. Because you know why? That would mean only one thing. That would mean that now the white man's kingdom falls while the Israelite kingdom rises up. While the blacks and Hispanics and Native American Indians rise up and governs this planet. Because obviously, the current landlords are no good. The current landlords are slumlords, you understand? Who pollute everything, water, the food, the air. Come, the slumlord I'm referring to is the white man. He's the slumlord of the earth, and the criminal of the earth, and the murderer of the earth, you understand? That's what we're talking about. So Donald J. Trump is doing a great job as a president to bring America to war. And you Christians don't want war, but we want war for the simple fact is so that way the black man can finally rule this planet. You understand? Let's get Joel. Joel, the third chapter, and we can go right to the third verse. You understand? Let's go right to the third verse. You understand? This Bible has been prophesying for the longest a coming World War III. You understand? It's been prophesied the First World War, which passed, and the Second World War. Now everybody thought that after them two world wars, that was it. It was done. It was over. Unfortunately for a lot of you Christians, church-going Christians, that only want peace and not war, but guess what? The scripture said there's a time for peace and a time for war. And guess what time we're in right now? We ain't in party time. We ain't in that time. We ain't in peace time. Right now, we in war. And guess what? War is about to get nuclear. Because it's in the Bible. Joel 3 and 30, and start 3. 3 and 3. You understand? World War 3 is at hand, Mr. White Man. Are you ready for it? Are you ready for it, Mr. White Man? Because guess what? The judgment is coming. The judgment is already written. Read.
The book of Joel, chapter 3, verse 3. And they have cast lots for my people.
Go to nine.
The book of Joel, chapter 3, verses 9. Proclaim ye these things, the Gentiles.
Again.
Proclaim ye this among the Gentiles.
Okay. And what we're going to proclaim among the Gentiles, meaning who are the Gentiles? The Gentiles are non-Israelites. The Gentiles are not black people, Hispanic, and Native American Indians, who are the Israelites according to scriptures, according to the Bible. You know what I'm saying? The Gentiles is everyone else, the Ethiopian, the Nigerian, the Chinese, the Japanese, all the white, all the whole white race, the Polynesians, the Arabs, the East Indians. You understand? Those make up the Gentiles. So we out here proclaiming what?
Prepare war.
This is what God said. Prepare war. Read.
Wake up the mighty men.
The Lord is telling you to wake up your mighty men. Who are your mighty men? Your soldiers. Go tell your mighty generals to get ready to form a plot for this battle on the world stage. You understand? Form all your strategic movements. Make sure all your pawns and your rooks and your knights are placed where they need to be placed. Because war is coming to America. Destruction is coming to the whole entire world war. You know what I'm saying? It's coming right to the Middle East. But right now, that war is going to take flight. It said, proclaim this among the Gentiles. Prepare war.
Wake up the mighty men. Let all the men of war draw near.
Let all of them, every last one of them soldiers, draw near. Where is they going to draw near to? They're going to draw near to the Middle East, where it's the Valley of Jehoshaphat. You understand? Syria is in Syria in the Middle East, right? But guess what? There's a war about to pop off. Donald Trump wants to send missiles because he's claiming, right? He claiming that Assad, right, which is the Syrian president, is using chemicals on its own people, which is a lot of nerve from a hypocritical nation, because every day they do it in the black neighborhood. Every day they do it in the Hispanic and Native American in the neighborhood. They're placing chemicals there to destroy black people. It's called heroin, marijuana, mollies, you know what I'm saying? Mescalines, what else? You know what I'm saying? All kinds of drugs, cocaine, crack. Those are the chemicals that the white man used against black people, against the children of Israel. So now, Donald Trump want to be the superhero, right? And say, well, Assad is using chemicals on his own people. You understand? But guess what? Russia's response was, well, you bomb Syria, there's going to be danger. We're going to bomb you. That's what Russia answered back. Now, America, you got to really ask yourself a question. Are you brave enough? You really got cojones to come up against Putin? You know what I'm saying? You're bold, right? You want to police the whole planet, even though you're wrong about a lot of things. Even though you are trying to front like you're the superheroes of the planet when you're the most criminal empire on the face of the earth. You understand? Now, are you really, really, really want to tangle with Russia? By all means, do so. As a matter of fact, there's nothing you could do because it's prophesied that the war between Russia and its allies and America and its allies is written of in the Bible. There's nothing you could do about it. So you might as well, since there's nothing you could do about it, you might as well prepare your men of war. Get them good and ready. Give them every type of weapon that they need, right? Give them every type of training and combat routines and all that and all the marching, you know what I'm saying, and the hoorahs and all that. Get your leathernecks ready. Get your Navy SEALs ready. Your Green Berets ready. Get all your generals ready, America, because war is at hand. What else you got?
Let them come up. beat your plowshares into sword.
Uh-huh.
And your pruning hooks into spear.
Right, normally the plowshares and your pruning hooks is used for what? Used for farming, right? But this time the Lord is saying to take those instruments and beat them until they become what? They become spears. What is the spear used for? Apparently it's used for war. It ain't used for barbecuing or shish kebab. It ain't for that. It's for war. You know what I'm saying? In other words, go prepare your tanks. Go prepare your missiles. Go prepare all your weaponry. Get all your armories ready, because war is coming to a city near you, Mr. White Man. You know what I'm saying? There's nothing you can do about it. You understand? You can try to go to the UN Council and see that it does not happen. You can try to postpone it. But World War III is coming to you, Mr. Wyman. Your empire deserves World War III. You know why? Because you have the children of Israel enslaved. And to this very day, you still keep oppressing us. You still are at war with us, even though we're not at war with you. So now the Lord got to make another nation, another race of people. Thank you, brother. Another race of people come up against you, because you want to war with innocent people. Since you want to be the bully of the earth, well, guess what? Now the Most High, he's going to bully you. Is there any more? Read.
Let the weak say, I am strong. Assemble yourselves and come, all ye heathen.
See that? Lord is talking to you, America, and all your allies. All the American allies, as a matter of fact, he also talking to the Russians and all their allies. You know what I'm saying? Get ready for it. This is the final showdown. You know how they prepare for that when they have the WWE Royal Rumble and they advertise it? Or when they have a UFC bout and they start advertising it, right? Make sure you come, buy your tickets early, you pay-per-view tickets, because there's the main event. Well, the main event here is America versus Russia. As it prophesied in the Bible. You understand? As it's prophesied in the Bible. America, that's the main ticket, Mr. White Man. America versus Russia. America and all its allies, and Russia and all his allies, all are going to war in the Middle East. Read it.
And gather yourselves together.
See that? Lord, making sure you hear this. Gather yourselves together. Gather you, your allies, everything. Everything that you need and that's necessary for war, for major war, for big time war, more grander than the Korean War. More grander than the Vietnam War. Y'all thought y'all seen war, right? Remember, we live in 2018. There's technologies in warfare that was never seen ever in the history of mankind. And in World War III, y'all about to see something majorly incredible. And it's all gonna get capped down with a cherry on top. What's that cherry? A thermonuclear bomb. Thermonuclear explosions. You understand? Get ready for it. Come together. Read.
And gather yourselves together round about. Thither, cause thy mighty ones to come down, O Lord.
See that? Call thy mighty ones to come down. Let me see where we are. Go ahead, go verse 12.
Verse 12, let the heathen be wakened.
See that? Right now you heathen, y'all laxed. Y'all relaxed, too lax, you know what I'm saying? Comfortable and enjoying your lives, right? Going to Disney World, seeing Mickey Mouse posing pictures with Power Rangers. You understand? Going to your Washington Caps hockey games. You know what I'm saying? Doing all the wonderful, great things. But guess what? Soon, y'all won't have time for that. The only time you're going to have is screaming and running, trying to run away from shots being fired. You understand? Trying to run away from shots being fired. So go ahead. Make America great for the last time. Make America great for the one more time, the last hoorah. Because World War III, your Make America Great president is bringing you to World War III. I don't know if y'all didn't see the news. I don't know if y'all seen where Russia said that America's in danger. I don't know if y'all realize it. Y'all better go check the news. Quick, fast, and hurry. You know, make America great. America's never been great. Let me tell you something. Not under the white man. It's been great when the Native American Indians ruled the land. It's been an excellent place, a wonderful place to live, until the devil came off the Mayflower and landed on the Plymouth Rock. And unto the devil rolled up in the Nina, the Pinta, and the Santa Maria, and landed 1492 somewhere in the Caribbean. America went downhill from that. While the Native American Indians and the Seminole Indians and the Aztec Indians and the Incas, you know what I'm saying, ruled so-called America, it was wonderful, it was splendid. But now they talk about make America great. Well, guess what? Tell that to Putin. See if America's gonna be great, because Putin already said he's going to war against America. Just go bomb Syria. Just go bomb Syria. America's, listen, let Donald Trump give the order. Black people, let's pray to the Most High in Christ that we stop smoking weed, that we stop whoring out our sisters, that we change our lives and do what's right. And beg the Lord to call Donald Trump to say, you know what? Let's bomb Syria. So that way people be like, oh, work. Let's bomb America. And then it's on. Then the Royal Rumble really begins. You know what I'm saying? Then it really comes to a city near you. Because guess what? Isn't it about time that we get up on top? Black people, let's keep it real. Aren't we tired of being on the bottom, scraping for a little measly chump change? You know what I'm saying? Here you go, a little wig hand out, a little turkey on Thanksgiving. What the hell with all that? I want rulership of the planet, and I want my people, blacks and Hispanics and Native American Indians, to be in rulership over the white man, porque ya sabemos que el hombre blanco es el diablo en la faz de la tierra. You know what I'm saying? The white man is the devil on the face of the earth. And it's about time that blacks and Hispanics and Native American Indians, we stop the beef with one another, because we are family, and come together like solid. You know what I'm saying? Come together like a chain link. Thank you, brother. Like a chain link that can't be broken. And you know what? When we do that, we're going to change our lives. And then after that, we're going to beg the Lord to cause Donald Trump to go ahead and give the order. Give you, I hope he do it soon. I hope he do it while we're speaking. They give the order to America to go ahead and bomb Syria. Y'all seen it on the headlines. Don't be fronting like y'all didn't see this on the headlines. Everybody woke up and be like, oh, snap. That little gut feeling that he get, like, oh, man, we ready? We there? It's almost that time. Yeah, it's almost that time. We reading it right here in the Bible. God, this was God's plan all along, you know what I'm saying? And then guess what? It's the right thing. You know why? Think about it. 400 years plus of lynching, of oppression, you know what I'm saying? Of Planned Parenthood in the black community, of gun violence in the black community and Hispanic and Native American Indians, of us being up in the, cramped up in the ghettos, out of the way so that white people could live a wonderful, beautiful life. Damn that. Your beautiful American white people is soon coming out of end. And I'm going to give the Most High and Christ a hand for that, because it's a beautiful thing. But I want to see the crying of white people. Oh, yeah. I want to see white people like, I just can't believe this. Oh, my gosh. Why is this happening to us? Let us help you out. Can we help them out? Get them a shot. Let me help you out. Because you've oppressed black people for 400 plus years. You murdered them still to this day for 400 plus years. You do all kinds of wicked things to the Lord's people for 400 plus years. And on top of that, you done messed the whole planet up. Everybody's mad at you. Every other race is mad at you. Black people, Hispanic, Native American Indians, we need to be mad. We need to be very mad. Not mad enough to pick up weapons, but mad enough to say, you know what? The hell with this blunt out the window. The hell with whoring out my sisters. The hell with the damn Christian church. None of that worked for me. I tried it all. I tried getting high. I tried whoring out my sisters. I tried the Christian church. None of that worked for me. But I'm so damn mad that today I've decided that I'm not going to do those things any longer and do what the Most High God says. So that way he can make Donald Trump push the button, make the call, pick up the red phone, bring, bring, bombs away. And then guess what? Then they can go sing that stupid Star Spangled Banner and let it burn with them. The hell with that stupid patriotic flag. That Stars and Stripes meant the death of Native American Indians. Them Stars and Stripes meant the death of Hispanic people. Them Stars and Stripes meant the death of black people. The stupid American flag, man. Because America has never been great for black people. Never been great for Hispanics and Native American Indians. Damn, we living in our brother's land, the Native American Indians. Why? Do I see a Seminole Indian in the neighborhood right now? Seminole Indians, where are you? Raise up. I don't see none. What's up with the Cherokees? Where we at? The Sioux, the Powhatans, What is that? You see the problem? We see the problem, right? This is their land. This is our brother's land. Shouldn't we be together with our brothers, being mad enough to change our lives, to turn back to the Lord and say, listen, white man, pale face, truly is the devil that the Bible speaks of. That's what we should be saying. You know what I'm saying? But we don't see them because they are forced into concentration camps. And it's so right that the Lord wanted to make World War III happen. Now, you Christians, y'all go Sunday morning and pick up a tambourine. Ain't that right, you girl? Right? I can't believe it. Captain, I hope and pray right now that the Lord does post, you know what I'm saying, make him push the button. So now I want to see the expressions of the Christian's face after they've been told that you drafted. You know what I'm saying? You're drafted into the military. They are kumbaya singing, right? Let's all join together. And the military sent them a green card. You've now been drafted into this war to Syria. And then y'all are trying to find your way to get out of it. It's too late. Because if you're dumb, what they do, they court-martial you. And then they throw you in prison. But guess what? You should go, because if you wanted to be a good old Christian and wanted to love white people, you know what I'm saying? Join with the white man, want to defend the white man while your brethren die on live TV, on YouTube feeds, and Facebook feeds. While our people are dying, you want to tell us to march and all that. The hell with that. The only marching I want to see these days is white Americans marching themselves to Syria. You know what I'm saying? That's what I want to see. I want to see white people being real patriotic and talking about, let's make America great again. Hey, Bob. Hey, Bob and Herbert, come with me. Let's make America great again. Dexter, are you ready? Dexter, I want them to pick up the weapons and march their behinds to the Middle East. You know what I'm saying? I want to see it. Because you know what I want to see? You ever seen the Roman candle? Y'all turn it out, what happens? You see different, it turns on and pops, right? A lot of flames. You know what I'm saying? That's what I want to see. I want to see if the white man can withstand the thermonuclear explosions. You know what I'm saying? I want to see if they're so powerful enough. And guess what? I already know they're not powerful. You know what I'm saying? We're dealing with the people that hate us. We're dealing with the people that are murderers. You know what I'm saying? We're dealing with the people that don't give a damn about black men. You know what I'm saying? And guess what? Don't be acting like because he gave you a slice of bread that now he's good peoples. Hell no. I'm smart enough, you know, I guess we're all smart enough to know that even if it come out the egg and it's a snake, right, it's still gonna bite you regardless. It's a snake. It just came out the egg and it might look cute, but once it bites you, you're done. And I know that much. I mean, it's common sense. But guess what? When I see their faces, the first thing I think about is, okay, they look around, make sure black people are fine. Okay, cool. I know they're not gonna be too fine that long, but you know what? For now, they're fine. We gotta be looking at, we always gotta be profiling white people, something that it's unheard of in black and Hispanic communities. We profile each other, but never profile the Sallys. We never profile the Billys and the Newts and the Dexters, you know what I'm saying? And the Jez, we don't never profile them when they're the real terrorists. And the Lord showed us this on the news. It took the Lord to bring it out on the news to show it to us that these people, you need to watch out for them because these people are dangerous. Dangerously so in the fact that they're monsters on the earth. You understand? And that's why the Lord got to make them come and go to war. Let Donald Trump go ahead and push that button. That's why the Lord said, proclaim ye this among the Gentiles. Prepare war. Where we at?
Let the heathen be wakened.
And guess what, heathen? Like we said, be wakened, be mustered up, be ready to go. Be every last one of you, be ready. You know what I'm saying? Make yourself combat ready for this war. Read.
And come up to the Valley of Jehoshaphat.
Right there, John. Valley of Jehoshaphat is right over there where Donald Trump want to go ahead and give the orders to send missiles to start bombing Syria. That whole Fertile Crescent, that Middle Eastern area, right there, the Valley of Jehoshaphat. Right there, look, it's like this, right? It's a bowl, it's a valley. You see? And guess what? What happens when you put things in the middle and try to run out? It's going to be very difficult, right? If you're in the valley, you're also easy targets. Because strategically, if you place people around on the rim of the valley, you can take people out. But, nobody escaping. You see that? See how the Lord playing them? The Lord positioning and all this. Let them come into the Valley of Jehoshaphat. Ain't no escaping this. You see that? No escaping this. And it'd be right from the Most High anymore.
Come. For there will I sit to judge all the heathen round about.
This is God talking to you, the white people, the Chinese, the Japanese. He's talking to all the Donald Trumps of America and all the Vladimir Putins in the world. He's talking to every last one of them and to their allies. He's saying he's going to sit there and judge. What the Lord mean by judge? That he's preparing a good killing. Like, you know how when black people get ready and make ready for a good old barbecue, right? We send out the plans and we go out, set up our barbecue grills and call all our family members to come out. Well, the Lord, he's setting it up where all these heathens got to come into this valley where it's going to be very hard for them to escape out this valley. You know what I'm saying? They're going to be easy targets once the perimeters are secured and muzzles are on them, scopes are on everybody, and war breaks out. You see that? The Lord is righteous. He's going to bring judgment on these heathens. You know why? Well, we gave you a few of them, right? The white man being the number one villain on the planet Earth, the number one criminal on the planet Earth, the number one child molester on the planet Earth, the number one drug dealer on the planet Earth, the number one animal make extinct person on the planet Earth, the number one polluter of water, the number one polluter of food and of land, the number one of everything. He's not right here. Look, he right here on top. He's the number one in everything bad that's for the planet Earth. Everything. You know what I'm saying? Like, these people truly need to be put into iron boxes. You know what I'm saying? They truly need to be there and stay there for the rest of their existence. You understand? They really need that because it's something that the planet Earth needs rest from white people. I'm going to tell you straight up and down. The planet Earth needs rest from white people because white people, all they know how to do is destroy, and they destroy with a smile and say it's good business. Destroy everything with a smile and talk about they being diplomatic. It's part of our diplomatic policies. Right. What, to kill whole communities? To kill whole countries, to damn pollute the whole earth, the water, the food, the air we breathe. It's all good business, right? You silly fools, you're damaging the thing you need too. You need to breathe air, you need to eat the food, you need to drink the water too, not just everybody else. But you're so dumb and retarded and stupid and a murderous mindset and a monstrous mindset that you have, you care about nothing else. You know what I'm saying? And God got to bring you to war. God got to do it. Read.
Verse 13.
I know, you know what I'm saying? Mr. Patriotic, make America great again. How can this Hispanic be saying those things? How can them black man be up on the microphone hoping that America falls? God wants America to fall. God wants America to be destroyed for the filth. And what matter of fact, Amos. Let's go. Look at Amos 5 and 12. The eye of the Most High is on this sinful kingdom. 9 and 8, alright? I'm going to show you this. God got an eye out for America. God got an eye out for the whole white kingdom. Because it's the most sinfulest thing on the face of the earth. You understand? Don't believe us. Don't believe what we're saying. But hear the word of God. Read.
Amos chapter 9, verse 8. Behold, the eyes of the Lord God upon the sinful kingdom.
See that? What kingdom that exists right now that is more sinful than a little bit? Only in America. What did the Don King say? Only in America, right? Don King. Only in America were you allowed to be a man to fall in love with a little boy and have a club called the Mambler Association. Only in America where they pass legislation that if you're on a naval ship, you can bring your pet dog and have sex with it. Only in America would they allow a man to be a woman and a woman to be a man. Only in America would they allow drugs and a high multitude value to come into the neighborhoods of blacks and Hispanics and Native American Indians. Only in America would they take the natives of the land and put them in concentration camps. Only in America would they enslave black people and then tell them to tie their boots and pick themselves up after you beat my brothers down for 400 plus years. Only in America does Donald Trump want to be a goddamn wall to divide Mexico and the United States. Only in America do they want to do these things to the children of Israel. But guess what? The eye of the Lord is on this sinful kingdom. Free.
Trying to find something to follow. Had loyalty, every man tried to borrow. Felt pain and a lot of sorrow. Got betrayed, sold packs. I didn't even have my heart broke. Living confused, about to lose hope. Cops got me on the side of the road like a sideshow. Need an antidote before I croak. Now I'm setting fire to rhythm man blues. Call this guitar smoke. Rebel with no cause, trying to find direction. The world got me vexed. Picked up a bad liquor habit that's hereditary from oppression. Felt like my life was on fire, trying to find an exit. Now look, 10 G's plus a good wreck. Sometimes a follower is a soldier, trying to find a good shepherd. Plus when you in hell, how do you excel? Wisdom the breath of life, I believe in fairy tale. Listen well to what I tell. No calling can cause pain. Something that a rebel knows very well. Can't you tell I was sent from the Lord? Got a tongue like a two-edged.